Hi, my name is Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about adding sine numbers. This is the first lecture. I'll have a couple, so we have some more examples, but this is the beginning part of this. So a sine number is just a number that has a sine in it. If we have 3, that actually means positive 3, right? We don't have to put a sine in front of positive numbers, but it's signed because there's an understood positive there. Or we could have negative 3. That has a definite sign in front of it. So that's what I mean by signed numbers, positive and negative numbers. So let's take a look at something you've already done before, something like 4 plus 5. These are signed numbers, and they have the same sign. So when they have the same sign, all you do is add those together. So you'd have 4 plus 5, and they'd have the same sign as the numbers that you were adding, which are called the add-ins. That's example number one. So all the rest of these are similar. 1a then, let's say I have negative 3 and negative 5. Now, when I put a positive next to a negative symbol like that, I usually separate them with parentheses. It doesn't mean anything except just to make sure that those two things don't bleed together, and you'll see that as a common way to write that. Negative 3 and negative 5, well, you have 3 negatives and you have 5 more negatives. So just like when you had all positives, now you're going to have all negatives. And that's going to be negative 8. You had 3 and 5, and if you count up all your negative signs, you've got a total of negative 8. If you have 2 plus 6, you've got 2 positives, and then 6 positives, you have a total of positive 8. If you have negative 10 plus negative 3, and I'm going to put that way again, then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 negatives, 1, 2, 3 more negatives. What would your answer be? Well, you have 10 and 3, you have a total of 13, and they're all negatives. So that's what's happening when you're adding two numbers that have the same sign. You just combine them together. You get more of the same, more positives or more negatives. But let's look at a different set. Let's say I have negative 5 and I add 2. Now I have a sign number of negative 5 and a sign number of positive 2. So what I have is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 negatives. I'm going to make positives just a different number so they show up a little. So I have 5 negatives, but I have 2 positives. And what happens are the negatives and positives, they cancel each other out. So this negative cancels that positive. My goodness, I wrote positive. Nope. And then this negative cancels that positive. And what's left over? Well, what's left over is the 3 negatives, right? And so sometimes you'll see books that explain it where the answer is going to have the sign of the number with the greatest absolute value. Remember, negative 5 would have an absolute value of 5. That's bigger than 2. Since we have more negatives, we're going to get an answer that's negative. So let's look at some more that are like this. Let's say I have 7 plus. Sometimes instead of putting parentheses, you'll see books that just float that negative sign up a little bit. So let's do that. Plus negative 5. So what would my sign be for my answer? Well, the question is, do I have more positives or do I have more negatives? Which number has the bigger absolute value? I actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 positives, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 negatives. I'm just using random colors here, but I want to use different colors so you can see what's happening. This positive cancels out a negative. This positive cancels out a negative. This positive cancels out a negative. And I keep going, canceling out one for one until I see what's left over. Well, what's left is my 2 positives. So I have an answer of positive 2. I could have seen that by asking myself, what do I have more of? Do I have more positives or more negatives? And after I finish asking myself that, I would say, I have more positives. How many more positives? So it's actually a subtraction problem, right, when you get down to it. All right, so 2b. Let's say I have negative 4 plus 7. So the question is, do I have more positives or do I have more negatives? Well, let's say I have 1, 2, 3, 4 negatives. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 positives. Well, I obviously have more positives. These four negatives could cancel these four positives. They would just go away. But I would still have 3 positives left over. So my answer is going to be +3. It doesn't matter which number comes first. Here the negative came first and it was negative. The positive came first, it was positive. But here the negative came first. It doesn't matter which one comes first. What matters is, what do you have more of? Do you have more negatives or do you have more positives? Okay, then let's see what we're going to do here. -8 + +8. Do I have more negatives or do I have more positives? Well, what you should be answering there is that you have the same number. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 negatives, but you also have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 positives. And so those 8 negatives are going to cancel those 8 positives and give you 0. Here's a little rule. Adding opposites gives you 0. Opposites, 8 and -8 are opposites. Anytime you add opposites, you get 0. That's the bottom line. Here's a bunch of problems for you to try. All right? So I'm going to number these 3. -7 + 2, 4. -8 + 5, 5, 7 + -9, -3 + 3, -7 - -9 + 0, -8 - -11 + 20. Okay, you should try those on your own and then come back and answer them after you've tried them on your own. What you want to ask yourself is, do I have more positives or more negatives? You have more negatives. How many more negatives? Feel free to write out your negative and positives, but you have more negatives by 5. What about in this one? Well, you have more negatives by 3. And you have more negatives here by 2. Here you have opposites. -3 and +3 are opposites, so you have 0. Here you have -9. 0 isn't negative or positive, so that is just going to be still -9. And here you have more negatives or more positives. Well, you have more positives by how many? By 9. If you wrote those out and compared those, that's what you see. So that's a very basic introduction to adding sign numbers in step number 2. We're going to go quickly back through these in the second video and then do some that are a little harder. I'll see you.